I am B.N. Ramakrishna, Assistant Professor, Department of Physics, Government College for Women, Autonomous, Mandya. My research topic is Optical Anisotropy of Liquid Crystals. The abstract of Optical Anisotropy of Liquid Crystals is: we report the results of our studies on optical and thermal properties of binary mixture of compounds with cholesterol nonanote CN and N exile 4 pentyloxy biphenyl 4 carboxylate 650 BC. The mixture, so these are the CN and 650 BC. These are the two compounds are used here, chemical compounds. The mixture exhibits a spherulitic texture of cholesteric phase and chiral induced smectic phases for different concentrations of CN sequentially when the specimen is cooled from its isotropic phase. The temperature variation of optical anisotropy of refractive indices, birefringence, density, and optical textures have been discussed. X-ray studies have been carried out to understand the intermolecular interactions in the mixture. Introduction. See, introduction to this topic is liquid crystals materials are of fundamental interest for a variety of applications in the areas of optical signal processing and photo induced phenomena. In recent years, a field of research that is growing steadily is the photo induced phenomena, in which the wavelengths of incident light impinge on the material's stability. Photostability of liquid crystal materials plays a crucial role in affecting the lifetime of liquid crystal display and memory devices. The experimental techniques used in this research topics are, so we have used Gibbon Japan polarizing microscope for study the optical texture studies, and refractive indices are studied by the instrument Abbe refractometer, and Joule X-ray diffractometer is used to study the various types of structural arrangements of molecules in the liquid crystalline mesophases. These three instruments are used in this experimental technique. See, if you come to the result and discussion part, first of all, we'll discuss about the optical texture. The Gibbon Japan polarizing microscope is one of the important equipment for the observations of the optical textures. The specimen was taken in the form of thin film and sandwiched between the slide and cover glass. The mixture of different concentrations of given molecules were slowly cooled from its isotropic melt. Microscopic technique are helps to show the stability of the liquid crystalline phases in the given binary mixture at different concentrations and at different temperature respectively. The optical texture has been taken by the microscope for the mixture with 40% of CN and 650 BC. The following micrographs shows the existence of spherulitic texture of cholesteric phase, focal conic fan shaped texture of smectic A phase, cirlon texture of smectic C phase, and hexagonal close packed smectic B phases. See, the micrographs observed are, so you have observed these micrographs, spirulitic texture of cholestic phase, focal conic fan shaped texture of smectic A phase, cirlon texture of smectic C phase, hexagonal close packed smectic B phase. Now we'll discuss about how to find the refractive indices. The refractive indices of liquid crystals are fundamentally interesting and practically useful parameters for the display applications. The optical refractive indices for extraordinary ray NE and ordinary ray NO of the mixture were measured at different temperatures for the different concentrations using Hubbert refractometer. The refractive index depends on the polarizability of the molecules and also depends on the order parameter. The following figure shows the temperature variation of refractive indices for the mixture of 40% of CN in 650 BC. See here, we have plotted a graph, refractive indices versus temperature for both the ordinary and extraordinary ray, that is shown in this graph. So here, for the increasing of temperature, you can see the different liquid crystalline phases like smectic B, smectic C, smectic A, cholestic and isotropic. In case of extraordinary ray, as temperature is increasing, the phases refractive index is keep on decreasing, whereas in case of the ordinary ray, as the temperature is increasing, refractive index for the ordinary ray is also increasing gradually. From this figure, it has been found that the mixture with small amount of cholestic material increases the required threshold of molecular orientation. And also, it is observed that the slope of the extraordinary refractive index NE changes at the temperature 82 degrees Celsius. You can see in the graph for the corresponding smectic phases, 82 degrees Celsius indicating the phase transition. Similar type of the behavior can be seen from the data of ordinary refractive index NO, which changes slightly at 82 degrees Celsius, indicating the smectic to cholestic transition. The ordinary refractive index NO increases slowly. On the other hand, extraordinary refractive index NE decreases faster with increasing in temperature. At 91 degrees Celsius, the refractive index changes sharply, which exhibits the cholestic isotropic phase transition. After the transition from cholestic isotropic phase, the value of refractive index remains almost constant, showing the isotropic phase of the material. Now, another important study is the birefringence studies. Here you can see the graph, the variation of birefringence with respect to temperature. As temperature is increasing, the birefringence of the liquid crystalline materials keep on decreasing. You can see the different phases of liquid crystals, smectic B, smectic C, smectic A, cholestic and isotropic. Birefringence property and its dependency on molecular orientation play an important role to understanding the molecular mechanism. Moreover, birefringence announcement is of primary importance for the innovation of different electro-optic applications. The figure shows the temperature variation of birefringence. From the figure, it has been found that the birefringence decreases slowly with increases in temperature, and the curve changes with slope at 82 degrees Celsius. You can see in the graph, indicating smectic to cholestric transition. It is corresponding to 82 degrees Celsius. Now, another important study is the X-ray study. See here, you can see the graph, layer spacing versus temperature. As temperature increasing, the layer spacing of the liquid crystalline material increases for smectic C phase, and almost constant, layer spacing is almost constant with increasing of temperature for the smectic A phase. In this study, X-ray is an important tool for understanding the layer spacings of smectic A and smectic C phases. The figure shows the temperature variations of layer spacings on smectic A and smectic C phases. From the figure, it is very clear that temperature increases. As the temperature increases, the layer spacing also increases in smectic C phase, but in smectic A phase, the layer spacings are almost constant. You can see in graph. Here, it is pertinent to remark that the smectic C phase has a layered structure in which the smectic layer normal and the director are no longer collinear. At the smectic A to smectic C transition, molecules start to tilt with respect to the layer normal, and layer spacings or decreases correspondingly. The molecular tilt is the order parameter for the smectic C phase. Molecular orientations are the better understanding of molecular tilt and the phase transition. Now, so if you come to the conclusion part, in light of the above results, we have drawn the following conclusions. The Meissner mixtures of 650 BC and CN materials exhibits different liquid crystalline phases, showing the formation of spherulatic texture of cholestric induced chiral smectic phase respectively at different temperatures. The experimentally measured refractive indices and optical birefringence study helps us to understand the molecular interactions of cholestric to smectic phase. The X-ray study lends support to the layer spacings of smectic A and smectic C phases respectively at different temperatures. Thank you.